Hey guys, it's Ping with Vital MX, and we're here at Cahuilla Creek Raceway today. Track's awesome, having a good time, and we've got our latest race shop build, which is our 2021 Kawasaki KX450. This bike won our shootout. It's incredible right out of the crate, so not a lot needed to be done to this thing. So as we're kind of building a theory around this project, there really wasn't much to do other than say, okay, what would I do to this if I was gonna go take it racing right now? What are the little tweaks I'd make to customize it to me and just give it that little sharpening kind of polish that I would want to go racing with it? So there's not a whole lot done to it. Start with the handlebars and grips. I love ODI. We threw ODI the RC bend bar on with their lock-on grips. I've always struggled a little bit with lock-ons because they're a little bit fatter. But ODI has done a great job of building these that still feel really thin, but it's so nice to be able to just slide them on and twist an Allen head and you're done, you know, not messing with glue and letting it dry and it's dripping all over the bike. So I'm really stoked on those. We put a better wheel set on. This is a W wheel set that's got DID rims, some Talon hubs in that magnesium color, very, very cool looking. W does a great job. They're incredible. All the stuff they build is top, top quality. Just for reliability and a little bit of bling, to be honest, we like to put these wheels on. But it is a firmer wheel, you're not gonna dent it, it's not gonna get out around nearly as easy as a stock one would. We put a rocket exhaust on it, and we had the guys at Twisted Development basically tune the mapping for that exhaust. What that did, according to Jamie and the guys at Twisted Development, is basically cleaned everything up. You know, you can sharpen up that jetting just to get it a little bit crisper. And I didn't want the power character changed. I think the stock Kawasaki power, even though on a dyno it's not the best, it doesn't make the most peak, but it's a very usable power. I think whether you're an intermediate expert rider or beginner novice, you get on this bike and it's just easy to ride. It's just a very usable power. I said, I don't really wanna change that. If we can enhance it everywhere a little bit, that's cool, but I don't wanna shift all the power to one side or the other, and it's exactly what it did. The rocket system just sort of enhanced the stock feel. Jamie and the guys over there, just with the mapping cleanup, just crispened it up a touch. It's really nice, so stoked on that. We didn't do anything else. Threw a Pro-X air filter in it, and that's all we did for performance. This bike has fantastic suspension right out of the box. If you were going to be racing at a very high level, maybe it'd be a good idea to get it valve for you, or if you're very heavy, very light, you might need to make some changes. We went to JBI. We've worked with JB before. He does a great job with these. He just freshened up the oil, put a little bit different spring in it. I kind of suited it to me, and it's definitely more progressive. Like, it has more of a racy feel to it right now, where if I go out and I'm just cruising, it feels a little bit more harsh than the stock stuff would. But the minute I start pushing it hard, riding as hard as I can go, it's more stable, more planted. I can push into stuff harder and it doesn't blow through like the stock stuff might. So it's a very racy setup. So he kind of gave me what I was looking for, but I just got to ride it hard to make it work. So I guess that's on me. Man, that was really it for performance. The rest of it was a lot of aesthetic stuff. A Cherbis, we went to them for the plastic. We said, let's do something weird, just something to turn heads. We posted something on Instagram. So far, it's about 50-50. Think it looks like a Smurfmobile or think it looks trick and different. So whether you love it or hate it, it's different. I just think it's cool that these companies are coming up with different plastics. So A Cherbis sent us the plastic. Decal Works matched the graphics to it and came up with that scheme. So it's definitely different. And then Moto Seed actually is adding a bunch of colors to their lineup, so they had colors to match it exactly. I mean, like I said, love it or hate it, definitely is different. A lot of Works connection pieces to just little green caps on the brake and different things like that to make it look a little sharper. And we didn't do too much else to it. You can obviously throw foot pegs on it. I like having a good platform, but these are good pegs. You just take a file and sharpen the teeth up a touch, and man, they're great. There's really, you don't have to go out and buy $500 titanium pegs. It's not necessary. I want to mention we threw Dunlop tires on this bike, the ones that I like, which is the 53 front and the 33 rear. To me, it's a perfect combination because that front is almost as good as the 33 in soft and wet, but much better in firm and hard pack. And then the rear is just such a broad range. You can ride that thing on hard pack or deep sand and it's great. I in my entire career, have not ever used a set of tires that is this broad range. You know, I can throw these on and ride all year on the same ones, and it'll work everywhere. So I love this tire combo. So if you're if you want to try something, I recommend it. Give it a shot. Want to mention a couple more people. Sunstar sprockets, we threw their sprockets on, mounted up great, looked great. They have them in different colors. And then we also threw a Pro-X chain, which those guys make all kinds of parts, a lot of stuff that wears out if you're rebuilding cables, gaskets, internals, man, you name it, they make a ton of stuff. And so they sent us some different things to try. Like I said, we threw the air filter in and the chain on, and works great. Anyway, on the track, like I said, I love this bike. I knew I'd love it today. The suspension's a little more racy, I had to push it. Motor is just an enhanced version of stock, which I love, it's great. And the bars, everything was super comfortable. This is a bike I can go out and just have fun on, feel comfortable right away. There's something about this Kawasaki, they just nailed it with the chassis and the suspension and the engine package. So they've done a great job. Super fun bike, and all we did was take a great motorcycle and kind of cater it to me. And so obviously I'm happy. So thank you to all these companies involved. We appreciate their support on these builds. And we got some weird different stuff coming for you. Some really neat projects coming up with David Bailey and Steve Lampson. So I'm excited for you guys to see those. But a lot of interesting stuff coming. We're just trying to bring you some new and unique content. Hope you appreciate it. We'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching.